And then Nuh alayhi salam will continue his da'wah until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to him, Allah azza wa jal revealed to him a revelation that was the last da'wah of Nuh alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to Nuh alayhi salam, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأُوحِيَ إِلَى نُوحٍ أَنَّهُ لَنْ يُؤْمِنَ مِنْ قَوْمِكَ إِلَّا مَنْ قَدْ آمَنَ فَلَا تَبْتَأِسْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَفْعَلُونَ. Allah revealed to Nuh alayhi salam, O Nuh, no one beside those who are around you became believers will become believer anymore. That's it. So don't bother. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to Nuh that no one will become a believer after those 80 people who are around you, or those people around you will become believers. So don't bother, because no one is going to become a believer. That's it. The hidayah is closed on these people. Subhanallah. Khalas. Revelation from Allah saying to Nuh, don't waste your time anymore. Whoever you're going to call, whoever you're going to speak to, whoever you're going to preach to, no one is going to listen to you anymore. And if they're going to listen, they're not going to be guided. وَأُوحِيَ إِلَى نُوحٍ أَنَّهُ لَيُؤْمِنَ مِنْ قَوْمِكَ إِلَّا مَنْ قَدْ آمَنَ. Allah revealed to Nuh that no one from your followers, no one from your tribe or your people will follow you except those who already became believers. So Nuh alayhi salam, he made dua on them. Nuh alayhi salam made dua on his people. And he said, Nuh alayhi salam, he said, O Allah, do not keep a kafir on the surface of this earth. O Allah, do not keep a kafir on the surface of this earth. He made dua on them for Allah to destroy the kafirin. And Allah accepted the dua of Nuh. And Allah Azza wa Jal destroyed all the kafirin in a way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah Azza wa Jal in a way that subhanahu wa ta'ala with his wisdom and the hikmah of Allah Azza wa Jal, his knowledge, he destroyed all the kafirin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to Nuh to build an ark, a ship. And to build that ship or ark in the middle of the desert, in the middle of the land. Usually you build a ship, hey, you need to build it next to the ocean, next to the sea, next to the river. So at least that ship goes down in the river and be used. What's the point of you building an ark in the middle of the desert on a mountain? So Nuh alayhi salam was ordered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to build a ship. And alayhi salam started to build the ship with the guidance of Jibreel. Jibreel came down teaching Nuh alayhi salam how to build that ship, the ark. And he told him, Nuh, what experience does Nuh have? Nuh, what experience does Nuh have in building a ship? What experience does Nuh have in putting wood together? What experience does Nuh have in building a massive ship or an ark? So Jibreel alayhi salam came down teaching Nuh how to build the ark. And Nuh stayed 100 years building the ark. Nuh alayhi salam stayed 100 years building the ark. And the people of Nuh will come and mock Nuh alayhi salam and say, Oh Nuh, did you become a carpenter after your prophet? So what, you're a builder now? You're a carpenter? We thought you're a prophet. And they'll mock him. And then they told him, Oh Nuh, you build a ship in the middle of the desert over a mountain? There's something wrong with you. There is something wrong with you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned how that every time come past, they go past Nuh and they say, وَيَصْنَعُ الْفُلْكَ وَكُلَّمَا مَرَّ عَلَيْهِ مَلَأٌ مِّن قَوْمِ سَخِرٌ مِّن. While he's building the ship, while they're building the ship or the ark, they'll come past Nuh and they mock Nuh. سَخِرٌ مِّن. They mock him, make fun of him. So Nuh will respond back and say, قَالُوا إِن تَسْخَرُوا مِنَّا. If you are mocking us and making fun of us, فَإِنَّا نَسْخَرُ مِنْكُمْ كَمَا تَسْخَرُونَ. We will mock you the way you are mocking us. Just a bit of a time. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them mock them in this dunya and the hereafter. So Nuh alayhi salam will start building the ship. 100 years building that ship. And Nuh alayhi salam, at that time there wasn't many trees in his area. So Nuh alayhi salam will plant that tree, wait for it to grow, and then Nuh alayhi salam will cut that timber and put it into the ark. 100 years until it became a massive ark. How massive? How big? They narrate, it's 300 arms length, the arms length of Adam. So they say it's 1,000 meters long. That's about 1 kilometer. And it's 50 zira', 50 zira' width from the zira' of Adam, which is about 200 meters width. And it's 30 zira', 30 arms length height, which is about 100 meters high. 100 meters high. See this? That's not even 5 meters. It's 100 meters high. And it was 3 stories. It wasn't an ark or a ship that's opened. It was closed like a bull. Closed. Because Allah told Nuh it was going to rain. So close it. It was a closed ark. 3 stories. 3 gates. For every story, 1 gate. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said about this ark, وَلَقَدْ تَرَكْنَاهَا آيَةً فَهَلْ مِنْ مُدَّكِرٍ. And we had left this ark, we had left this ship as a sign, a miracle to the Day of Judgment. And this ark till this day exists. They found a part of it in Turkey, and there's other parts that Allah said stays. Allah alam, hidden, where, who knows about it? But this ark till this day stays to the Day of Judgment, as Allah Azza wa Jalla said in the Quran Kareem. And Nuh alayhi salam will continue to build that ship. And he built it. He built it alayhi salam with nails. There was nails. Allah taught him how to put the nails together. That alwahin wa dusur, as Allah said in the Quran Kareem. Alwah, timber, and dusur is nails. Allah mentioned there was nails, timber, put together everything. And Allah taught him how to build it. 100 years, ikhwani. 100 years to build an ark. And a massive ark. Binwa'. Being designed and architected by Jibreel alayhi salam. Jibreel alayhi salam showed him how to do it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Nuh alayhi salam, He gave him a sign. When that sign takes place, take you and your family and your followers and from every animal, different genders, male and female, and go into the ark. And Nuh alayhi salam waited for that sign. And that sign is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَإِذَا فَارَ التَّنُّورِ فَإِذَا فَارَ التَّنُّورِ. And what's the tannur? Tannur is the old oven. The old oven they used to use. If you go back in one of the old towns in the Middle East, there's old ovens they use, yani certain timber inside, and they use it for bread. They call it tannur or furun. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, when water starts to come out of the tannur, then that's the sign for you to get to the ark. And Nuh alayhi salam waited for that sign. And one day, fara tannur, water exploded out of the oven. So Nuh knew it's time. He called upon his followers and went to the ark. And in front of the ark, all the animals from the different genders were waiting in line to enter the ark. Subhanallah, rahmah, Allah's miracles. From every animal, male, female, was waiting outside the ark. And Nuh alayhi salam went with his 80 of his followers and his family and his wife. And Nuh was married to a wife before that, she was a kafir. And that's where Allah Azza wa Jalla said, وَضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا امْرَأَةَ نُوحٍ وَامْرَأَةَ لُوطٍ. امْرَأَةَ نُوح, she used to be from the non-believers. For Nuh had a non-believing wife, she passed away. Then Allah Azza wa Jalla gave him a believing wife. And he had 4 boys. He had Ham, Wasam, Yafeth, and Kan'an. 3 of those, Sam, Ham, Yafeth, were Muslims, and Kan'an was a non-believer. And Nuh told him, son, come aboard, be with us. He said, Sa'awi ila jabalin ya'simuni min al-ma. Don't worry, I'll survive. I'll go to a high mountain and I'll protect myself. I'll go to a high mountain where I'll protect myself. There's no need. He told him, son, be from the believers or be from among us. Be with us. Kan'an refused. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took him with the rest of the non-believers being destroyed in the flood. And Nuh alayhi salam will enter the ark, the animals in one place, the human beings in another, and they'll stay in the ark for 6 months. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will order his punishment to come down. Allah azza wa jal, he says, فَفَتَحْنَا أَبْوَابَ السَّمَاءِ بِمَاءٍ مُنْهَمِرٍ وَفَجَّرْنَا الْأَرْضَ عِيُونًا فَتَقَى الْمَاءُ عَلَىٰ أَمْرٍ قَدْ قُدِرٍ. People think Allah Azza wa Jalla just sent rain. Allah said in this way, فَفَتَحْنَا أَبْوَابَ السَّمَاءِ, we opened the gates of the heavens. It wasn't just rain, just the gate of the heaven. The gates of the heavens just opened and rain will come down. Not like a normal tap, but a big explosion just came down of water. And not only this, وَفَجَّرْنَا الْأَرْضَ عَيُّنَا, Allah Azza wa Jal exploded from the ground springs with water coming out. So water from the top, water from the bottom. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَالْتَقَى الْمَاءُ, both water met together, عَلَىٰ أَمْرٍ قَدْ قُدْر, an order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that this water covered the highest peaks of the mountains. Fully. Not only Allah, the Arabian Peninsula, but the whole world was covered with water. The whole world was covered with water, even above the mountains. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described the ship as like waving over mountains. Subhanallah, when Allah azza wa jalla wants to destroy a nation, Allah will destroy them in His way, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Nuh alayhi salam will be in that ship and ark, him and his believers for 6 months. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered Nuh to make dua, Rabbi anzilni munzalan mubarakan wa anta khayrun munzilin. Well, Allah, make me land on a good landing, and you are the best of those who give hospitality. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah azza wa jal, for 6 months protected Nuh and his followers in the ark. And then Allah azza wa jal ordered the ground to swallow the water. وَقِيلَ يَا أَرْضُ بْلَعِي مَاءَكِ, oh ground, swallow your water. So the ground swallowed the water. And then the flood's gone. Nuh alayhi salam is in the cover. He doesn't know. 6 months under the rain. Water from the top, water from the bottom. So Nuh alayhi salam used to send bird. He used to send a pigeon. And every day that pigeon would come back wet and with nothing. So one day he sent the pigeon and it came back with a leaf from an olive tree. So Nuh realized that now the water is drying. And then after that, a few days, he sent that pigeon again. It came back with mud on its feet. So Nuh realized that now the water is dry. And where did the ark stop? It stopped on a mountain called Judee. Mountain called Judee. And that mountain is in Turkey. And then Nuh alayhi salam came out with 80 people, and only 80 people living on the surface of this earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him and those 80 people and the rest of the animals. And the rest of the animals. And Nuh alayhi salam came out knowing that there is no one living on the surface of this earth. And not only this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made all the followers of Nuh not to have any descendants.